Recently, I made a video showing how I control my ATM Mini Pro switcher using TouchOSC MK2. In this video, I will show you how I added OBS controls on the same layout in TouchOSC MK2. If you are using OBS and looking for a way to remotely change scenes in OBS, continue watching this video. Welcome to another episode of Amazing Sticky Presentations, inspired by Sticky Spy, bringing you tips, ideas, design for better presentations, turning your ideas into lasting impressions. Hey, if you are new to this channel and don't know me, my name is Tian Teck, and I help individuals communicate with confidence through high-impact presentations. I was using Stream Deck to remotely switch scenes in OBS until a few weeks ago, where my Stream Deck suddenly died. All buttons on my Stream Deck turned white, and I couldn't get it to work. Fortunately, it was still under warranty, and I managed to get a replacement. While waiting for the replacement, I needed to use OBS for my live event before my replacement unit arrives. And that makes me look for solutions that will work with TouchOSC on my iPad to remotely change scenes in OBS. And I found OSC for OBS. It's a software like ATM OSC. It sits between OBS and TouchOSC as a way to allow communication between TouchOSC and OBS. So what I'm going to do is to show you how I configure OSC for OBS. It's quite similar to the way ATM OSC was configured to control the ATM switcher. We also need OBS web socket plugin for the whole thing to work. I will provide all the links to download the softwares in the description area. Once everything is installed, we need to launch OBS and then OSC for OBS. Okay, you could see that I'm running OBS on my computer right now, and I have already prepared three scenes on my OBS, which is right here. Let me show it to you. Camera, slides, and slides plus camera. So those are the three scenes that I prepared on my OBS already for this demonstration. Okay, so when I click on slides, definitely change to slides. My third scene is slide plus camera. So you can see that I have a slide together with myself on top of the slide. The other software that you need is OSC for OBS. So I have it running at my back in my background right now. And once you have launched OSC for OBS, and click the connect button, and once it get connected to OBS software, it will scan OBS to see what kind of scenes that you have. Right now, after here in this example that I show, it already shows me that I have three different scenes: camera, slides, and number three is slides plus camera, which is corresponding to my OBS software, right? The scenes on my OBS software that I showed you earlier on: camera, slides, slides plus camera. Okay, so the next thing that I need to do is to ensure that my OSC out has an IP address of my TouchOSC device, right? So if I'm going to run my TouchOSC on maybe an iPad or an iPhone, this should be the IP address of the iPad or the iPhone that is going to run TouchOSC interface. Let me bring out TouchOSC right now on this computer, and I'm going to show you how I create those buttons that is able to switch the scenes with a blank layout. So what I'm going to do is to create buttons so that I can use those buttons to control my OBS scenes. Right, so I'm going to create this button here. I want the outline of the button to be solid, right? So instead of corner, I'm going to change it to full. Okay, and from there, the button would be momentary button. I want it to be only activate when it's pressed, and do not want it to activate when it's released. So it's only activate when it's pressed. From there, I do not need the MIDI messages. I'm going to use OSC message. So I'm going to delete that at the MIDI part. And okay, enable send receive. That's okay. I'm going to use connection number two, right? The connection number two instead of connection number one, because the connection number one, I'm using it to control my ATM. For connection number two, I'm going to use it to control my OBS, right? At the same layout. Okay, so our trigger using X and any would be rise. So when X amount rise, it will then trigger, right? I don't need the name. Let me delete away the name and the address, right? The address, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to put in scene, right? So scene/, and it would be the name of the scene in OBS. So I'm going to call it cameras. That's the first scene, right? The first scene, camera. Okay, so how do I know, you know, where to get all this command? So if you go back to OSC for OBS, and then you move to the help, right? Or before you move to the help, if you could take a look at the read a little bit details here. Under the available scene, it says reference help API for all OSC commands, right? So all I need to do is to ensure that I go to help and then OSC API, right? And once I get there, you could see that it lists down, it goes to a website and lists down all the available commands for OSC. And what I want to do is to use this one, you know, by TouchOSC, scene/scene name, right? And that's what. So for example, I have a scene. If the name of my scene is white, then I just type in white, right? So in my example there, the name of the scene that I have is camera, right? Good, so I have that one. So the next thing I want to do is to name this button. Let me move the button here and name the button. So I'm going to add in a label, right? And the label, I'm going to call it, not label one, but the name of the label is camera. So I do not want the background, right? I do not want the outline. So I want a blank. Oops, it's not. Oh, sorry. So it should be under text, right? Under text label, I would say camera. Yes, camera under the text. Right. So to create a second button, all I need to do is to select the whole button, make a copy, right? Make a copy and then make a paste again, right? So do a paste. It's going to paste on top exactly. So I'm going to move it to my next so that I can my next scene. So let's name the button first, right? So the name of the button, I'm going into, instead of camera, I call it slice. Slice. And definitely I have to change the command in the button, right? So I click on the button now and I'm going to change the command instead of scene camera, right? Instead of scene camera, I'm going to change it to scene slice. Okay, S-L-I-D-E-S, slice, scene slice. That's what I'm going to do, right? So scene slice. So the third one, I'm going to make another back camera that says slice plus camera, right? So I'm going to do a paste again, right? Have it there. Let's name it first, change the label to slide plus camera. Okay, let's widen it a little bit. Okay, now click on the button and let's change that address, right? Change the address. Instead of camera, I would have slides plus camera. Okay, so I have that three different buttons that I can click on it and then later on change to a different scene on my OBS. Okay, so in order for me to ensure that's running, I have to make sure that I have my connection number two. Okay, so my host address is 127.0.0 because I'm running everything on the same computer. If you are running it on an iPad, for example, in this case, your connection that you are doing here would be the address of the IP address of the computer that is running OBS. Okay, that is running OBS. Okay, so in order to make this button run, all I need to do is click on this play button here. So you can see that, click on the play button, and then I have that scene running. Okay, so right now let me move it aside and let me expose OBS. Okay, let me just do that. Okay, so you could see that now I have my camera, I'm clicking on it, and to change the slide, I just click, wow, it comes to the slide. And if I'm going to click on slide plus camera, it will have slide plus camera, all right? Oops. Let me see. Okay, so slide. So you could see that I am there, right? So I can easily just click and switch. So if I have this interface, which is a TouchOSC interface on my iPad, so all I need to do is that remotely from my iPad, I just click on the button. Okay, and I can easily change the screen. So during my live streaming, what I need to do is to be able to focus and concentrate on the audience. And at the same time, if I need to change to a different scene, all I need to do is touch on the iPad, right? To change to a slide or change back to camera or have slide plus camera together on the same page itself. You also realize that by doing this, if I do make a change of the scene on my OBS directly, right? Okay, let me make this OBS a little bit smaller. Okay, if I do make the change on my OBS directly on the scene, my TouchOSC itself on my iPad will also change, right? The button itself will also change on the highlight. So this can happen because of the IP address that you have tell OSC, what was that? OSC for OBS, right? Where is the iPad located, right? Used by IP address, right? So from there, I can do that. Camera, slides, or camera, slides. So that is how you would ensure that you configure your OBS together with OSC for OBS to allow TouchOSC to be able to control OBS. It's a mouthful, I know, it's a mouthful. So this was how I created buttons on my TouchOSC MK2 to control my OBS. If you are controlling your ATM switcher alongside with OBS on the same TouchOSC layout, you will need to assign a second connection in TouchOSC connections configuration with associated ports and IP information. If you are still watching, do me a favor. Click on the like button to help me share this video to more viewers. And if you like my content, I hope that you will subscribe to my channel by clicking on the subscribe button below. It will encourage me to make more videos and continue sharing my content for free. Here is a short demo on what I have done for my workflow. I can switch to different scenes on my OBS by just touching on the button on the TouchOSC layout running on my iPad. I hope this video is helpful in getting you started with OSC for OBS. Have you used OSC for OBS in your workflow? Let me know what is your use case. Until my next video, have fun and create awesome touch controls for your OBS using OSC for OBS. Bye bye.